Hello, I'm Gavin Hoey. Now, last week I did a 15-minute challenge at Borkham Viaduct, and many of you got in contact asking, how did I do the pictures? What did I do in Photoshop that made them look so great? Well, to be honest, I'm quite happy to show you how I do them in Photoshop, and I'll do that in just a minute. But really, it started long before I was in Photoshop. It all starts with the camera settings. And there's one big setting that you need to be using to get the very best from your digital images. So, on my digital camera, what I've done is to set my camera up to shoot raw photos. Okay, so you can put the raw format in, and that will give you the best possible start with your pictures. Now, once you've got your pictures in raw, all you need to do is get back into the studio, into your office, sit in front of the computer, and I'll show you what you do next. Okay, so you join me in Photoshop. Well, at least it's not Photoshop, it's Adobe Camera Raw. And this is the halfway house between the raw picture your camera takes and Photoshop that you know and love. Now, using Adobe Camera Raw or whatever raw software you like to use, you can make quite significant changes to your picture, but still keep the quality as if it was an original shot. So looking at the picture here, what I saw in my mind was an image that had a lot more texture. I was really having one of those days where I wanted a sort of grungy feel to everything. So I'm going to enhance the texture on this picture. I'm also going to change the colours a little bit because I had my camera set to auto white balance, which is pretty much where it stays most of the time. But because it was quite a sort of daylight setting, I'm just going to pump it into daylight white balance, and that should just warm the tones a little bit more. Right, now I'm not going to fiddle with the exposure because the histogram up here looks nice and central. I'm not going to fiddle with the recovery or with fill light because I want to increase the contrast. Increasing the contrast will bring up the texture, and there are three sliders to look at to increase contrast. The first one is blacks. Now if I bring that black slider in, you'll start to see straight away what it's doing. It really does give a nice boost to the contrast. It kind of darkens the shadows a bit more. Now I'm going to come down to the obvious one for contrast, the one called contrast, and push that up. And that does exactly what it says. It increases the contrast over the whole picture equally. Finally, I'm going to come down to the clarity. Now, clarity increases contrast, but really only on the mid-tone areas. So this is a bit more selective, but nonetheless, it all enhances that contrasty look. So where do we come from? Well, we had that as our beginning picture and that as our picture. Now you can see this lovely detail coming out on the mud sections here. I really like that. My only worry with this is that the colours are a little bit too strong. So I could drop the saturation back, but I prefer to use vibrancy instead, because vibrancy doesn't change all of the colours equally. It takes the more saturated colours, those brown colours, and drops those down first. So you get a little bit more of a natural reduction in saturation. I find it a lot more user-friendly than just the saturation slider. And somewhere around about there looks pretty good. Now, one other change I'd like to make is to darken these corners down. There are a few ways you can do it in Camera Raw, but the most obvious way is to put a vignette on it. And we'll find that by swapping panels. We'll come over to the lens correction panel, and halfway down you'll find lens vignette. There are two options actually. You also get post crop vignette, but I really hate the look of that. It looks very, very different. So I haven't cropped this image. This is exactly what came off the camera. So I'm going to use lens vignetting and darken those corners down like so. Okay, so that's now having the look of the picture that I wanted. Again, to remind myself, am I heading in the right direction? This is what we started with, and this is what we're finishing with. So I kind of like that. So how long did that take? 2-3 minutes? Maybe 4, because I'm trying to explain as I go along. Well, I work a bit quicker when I'm on my own, but I work even quicker if I like a subject like this, a technique like this. I'll make a preset so I can apply it to other pictures. So let's turn this effect into a preset. So let's swap panels again. We'll go to the presets panel. We'll come down to the bottom where we find the new preset icon, and we can save everything here. Now you can choose what you'd like to save as a preset. I tend to leave everything ticked on because you can always come back and change things later. So kind of leave it there, but give it a name that means something. So this is the Borkham preset, because that's where these pictures were taken. Lovely. And there I have a new preset. Fantastic. Now, the advantage of this is that I can simply apply this same preset to other pictures. So, for example, if I bring up another one from that photo session, this one, I can jump back to my preset here, and there's the Balkan preset we made. Bang! It does it all. And have a look at the settings here. You can see what it's done. It's put the blacks up, it's put the clarity and the contrast up, and dropped the vibrancy down. So it did everything that I did, but just really, really quickly. Similarly with this one, we can come back to our presets here, and bang, in it goes. So you can see how much faster you can work with RAW, and specifically with RAW presets. Now, they're not set in stone, so you can come in here and you can change things. You think, well, maybe actually I'd like to push the vibrancy up a bit on that one. And there you go. So you can use these presets as a guide, and it'll make your correcting of RAW images much, much quicker, and you'll enjoy your photography much, much more.